Ever want to go foil driving on the beach? Well, here are five top beaches from Sydney to try out. Before we start, make sure you have something to deflate your tires with and something to inflate your tires with after you've got off the sand. And a bit of recovery gear wouldn't hurt.
All right, so they tell us that the sand is really soft here. So in order for us to drive on it, we have to air down. So I usually air down. So I have this little, like it's a tire gauge, but if you edge it the right way, you can let some air out. So I'm gonna go down to maybe 15 PSI.
For our first stop, only an hour away from Sydney is Boat Harbour, Kurnell. Now this beach is heavily patrolled, so if you're ever stuck out here, you'll always have the patrol ready to pull you out. It's a great place to stop, have a swim, and have a bit of lunch. And also, it's pet friendly, so Pippa really enjoyed her time here. The only con is that there's an entrance fee, but other than that, it's a great place to go, especially if it's your first time on the beach. It's a great beach to go on if you've never driven your car on the beach. The next beach is an hour and a half north from Sydney and is Blacksmith's Beach. It's a great place to fish, a great place to have a barbecue, and they offer campsites on the beach. You do need a permit for this beach, so make sure you plan ahead. Since this is a popular beach, you'll never be alone, and there's always a four-wheel drive to help you out if you ever get stuck. It's also a great place to gain a bit more confidence when driving on the sand, as the sand is just a tad bit softer than Boat Harbour. Another 30 minutes north from Blacksmith's Beach is Stockton's Beach. It's a 30 kilometers long beach stretching from Stockton to Anna Bay. It is regarded as the largest moving coastal dunes in the Southern Hemisphere. Fair warning, the sand here is usually quite soft, so make sure that you either have the appropriate recovery gear, so tracks, or you have a buddy along with you that can pull you out if ever you get bogged. The next beach is actually a recent discovery, and that's Sandbar Beach. Sandbar Beach is about a 3-hour drive up north from Sydney. This is pretty much just a huge sandbar that separates the beach from the lagoon. And if you got the time, there's a campground just outside of this beach. Last but not least is 7 Mile Beach in Lennox Head. It is a 7.5-hour trip from Sydney up north, but if you're heading to Byron, this is a great stopover. The sand is hard, so I wouldn't be too worried about being bogged. It's a great place for an easy beach drive, and it's also a great place to see the sunset. So there you go, guys. Those are our top 5 four-wheel drive beaches near Sydney. Hopefully this helps with your next trips. And if it does, please leave a comment and tell us what you think of them. And remember to like and subscribe for more videos. See you guys in the next one.